Welcome to the special episode of Rock Next Paramore Now. I'm VJ Chino, and last Feb 15, 2013, we all know that Paramore visited our country once again, and I was very lucky to get the chance to interview the band. What happened was, we were there at 5 p.m, so call time namin 5 p.m, concert na nila that night. And then I was there on time, Moa Arena. I was parked, so I was just waiting for the confirmation and everything else. And then, sakto-sakto lang yung dating ko dun sa Moa Arena for the interview. Tapos, Monty was there, Monty Macalino of Mayonnaise. He was helping me out with what questions I can ask Haley and the rest of Paramore, kasi he is a huge fan of the band. And Sir Andrew was there also to help me out slash manggulo sa akin. And later on, we will show you guys our exclusive interview with the band. But, for now, let's get to know the band more. Officially formed in 2004 with Jeremy Davis on bass, Josh Farrow on guitars, Zach Farrow on drums, and Haley Williams on vocals. The band's debut album, All We Know, and released their sophomore album, Riot, which spawned their hit, Misery Business.
It's sort of like a Mean Girls thing, you know, we just wanted to make a really fun video, and that's what it turned out to be.
The next single, Crush, 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 also did good on the U.S. charts. Welcome back to the special episode of Rock Mix called Paramore Now. In 2009, the band released their last album with the Farrow Brothers called Brand New Eyes.
So we're extremely pleased. It's amazing to see it do as well as it's done.
Trying to show the story that the song is about, which is about a girl who kind of is afraid of love, and she needs to go through a few different experiences to realize that it's okay to find it, to be open to it.
Destinations of the tour for this album was the Philippines, and I was very lucky to be able to interview them. Hey guys, I'm very thrilled right now because with me are three of one of the hottest rock bands today. We got Jeremy, Taylor, and Zach of Paramore. Yes. Yeah. So, welcome to the Philippines. So, how's your Asian tour so far?
It's been so good. It's had such a warm welcome. And whether it's like with the people or the, you know.
Yeah.
We didn't expect any of this, and it really is amazing. So, we're definitely planning on coming here more often, too.
Hey guys, I just finished my interview with three of the members of Paramore, namely Zach, Jeremy, and Taylor. Wala si Haley. It was a bit sad na wala siya. Pero okay lang kasi makikita ko naman siya later sa concert. And sobrang saya kasi even though kahit wala si Haley, they were able to answer my questions nicely. Tapos nakapag, medyo mapag-usap kami. So, iba kasi talaga yung feeling kapag nakapag-usap ka with international artist, diba? So, I was very happy. I was very thrilled at the same time. And hopefully, mas marami pang mga artist na punto dito para ulit yung ganun klase na experience, di ba? I was one of the fans that really rocked out to their concert back in the MOA Arena in 2010. I think that is why the band was really enticed to come back into the Philippines and perform once again to all of their fans. How was it the last time you guys were here? Anything you guys remember?
It was a really big show and really hot. But I mean, I think we love coming to this part of the world anyways. It's not something we get to do all the time. And the first time we came, we were so excited about just the reaction and how many people came out for the show. So we've been waiting to come back and like sound checking here and seeing the venue. It's so big. We're really excited to play.
That's crazy. It's such a fun ride. It's so blessed and honored to be able to go in lots of different countries and play to fans that are singing all the lyrics back to us louder than, you know.
Yeah.
It really is an amazing feeling. It's cool. I never expected we would actually get here, you know. And
there were also rumors swirling around that you guys were about to break up. Is that true?
No.
Okay.
We went through a really hard time, you know, growing up on the road and being so young. You know, we're figuring out every day, even now, who we are and, you know, what we want in our own lives and as fans. So naturally, through that, you know, we just kind of started, you know, kind of butting heads a lot. Because, you know, every band, you know, we also still go through stuff every day because we're not perfect. But we just definitely know we're going to do some breakups or anything like that. But we're up for it.
In December 2010, the Farrow Brothers officially left Paramore. And although the remaining members only had good things to say, Josh Farrow left the band saying that it was a manufactured product of a major label and that Haley treated the band as more of a solo project. Well, from my experience sa interview ko, parang hindi naman yata ganun. When I was talking to Taylor and Haley, it really seemed that it was a collaborative effort when they made the latest album. How grueling was it for you guys to record a 17-track album?
We had a really good time in the studio. I mean, you get tired towards the end of it, but it was fun. This was an experience that I think we've needed to have for such a long time, just to enjoy making the album and kind of like rediscovering our friendships together and also taking a lot of time off the road made it okay for us to spend that much time on the album.
Welcome back to our special episode of Rock Mix Paramore Now. I'm VJ Chino, and last Feb 15, 2013, Paramore revisited the Philippines for part 2 of Parathriller in Manila. And before the show, as I mentioned earlier, I got to interview the band. I was very nervous. You guys might think that since marami na akong na-interview na iba pang artists, it's still different when you get to interview a band or an artist that you really look up to. And the last time that I got to interview the band, wala si Haley. Hindi niya ako sinipot. So for this time, they told us that she would be part of the interview, so it really added to the pressure for me to do well, because ayoko mapahiya sa harap ni Hayley Williams. But she was very nice, she was very kind and helpful in a way na makonduct ko yung interview in a nice way for you guys. It is a great day, guys, because they are back for the second time around. Please welcome Taylor and Hayley of Paramore. Welcome back to the Philippines. And of course, I want to congratulate you guys for your upcoming album. It's your fourth one, and it's self-titled. So why did you guys decide to go for that, like a self-titled album?
I think, yeah, most bands do that, maybe their first album, and it's kind of, I think, a statement saying, like, this is who we are, and so I think we wanted to make that statement now, which is a bit unusual, but I think just going through everything we've been through, you know, we want people to know that we actually feel right now that we're more Paramore than we've ever been. So.
Nice. Yeah. All right, and how different is this album from the previous ones?
It's different. I mean, I think we've changed with every album, but this one is definitely the biggest leap. You know, I think we took a lot more chances in, you know, I don't know, I think we paid a lot more attention to our hearts, and we were really honest with ourselves and our influences, and I think even just having less cooks in the kitchen, I think we were able to be more creative and do more and experiment more, so it's definitely different, but I think people that liked our older music will still be able to get it, so.
That's good. All right, and I hear that you guys worked on a new producer for this album. Is that right? So how was it working with him?
It was awesome. His name is Justin Meldal Johnson. He produced the newest M83 record and Neon Trees, and he went out with Nine Inch Nails and played with Beck. And so, you know, he just has a really cool and interesting track record, which isn't really normal for a band like us to go with. And when we first met with him, it was just obvious that we had to work with him. And so it was great. He really pushed us and challenged us to kind of be open to new ways of thinking and new instrumentation. And so I don't think we could have done this record with anyone else.
And there are so many tracks in the new album, 17 to be exact, and 3 interludes including that. So what made you guys decide to include 3 interludes with the album?
Well, the interludes happened by accident. When we started writing the album, there were, you know, moments where we had, like, writer's block, we couldn't write, and the interludes came about just as, like, a funny way to deal with that, because writer's block can be really frustrating, and it's really discouraging sometimes, too, for bands. So instead of, like, letting it stall us, we sort of took it and tried to turn it around. And
you guys mentioned earlier that you guys really took your influences and tried to bring them for the latest album. So who are your influences? Who are the artists that you guys listen to?
There's a lot. I think, you know, collectively, like all 3 of us, you know, we really like Me Without You, which is playing with us tonight, which we're excited about. And, you know, we kind of pulled from some older stuff, sorry, like The Cure. And I know Hayley listened to a lot of Susie and the Banshees and a lot of New Wave stuff. We all kind of listen to a lot of different stuff, you know. And Jeremy really likes hip-hop, and Hayley kind of, she has her own thing, and I have mine.
All right, so can you guys name us a certain artist that we would be surprised that you guys listen to them?
I mean, I think Coldplay was different for people. Taylor was really, really into their record last year, and he did an interview. I don't know who you did the interview with, but
for some reason, everyone thought that our new record sounded like Alt-J, which is not true.
It doesn't.
But I like them.
Yeah, and that record really is amazing, but thank you.
We love it like that. Our single is already out, it's called Now, so what's the story behind it?
Now is, it's sort of a victory cry. It's kind of about believing before you see and reaching out for whatever's next in your life, and it's a message that we feel is really positive and want to stand by it. Concept. We, a lot of times in the past, we have come up with things with the director, and we really felt like, you know, with this album, we want to try new things. We just want to be open-minded to everything, and so basically, gave this really just had to do with, you know, good versus evil, love versus hate, and light versus dark, and so we kind of obviously play the sort of like rebel soldiers on this team fighting for love, and
the guy. So gotta edit that in. Very nice. All right. And do you guys have any plans for the next single after Now?
We don't have any definite plans yet, but we are excited to get there. You know, we just put out the video for Now, and I think it's really still exciting for us to see our fans sort of discussing what the song is about, what the video is about. So when it's the right time, we will wrap.
This might be extra loud when we show it on TV because you have two mics on you.
I'm sorry.
It's all good. So, of course, I'm sure you guys are all excited for the concert tonight.
Yes.
What can we expect from it?
I mean, it's just going to be a Paramore show. It's going to be loud, very, very loud, and crazy. And really sweaty, too.
I threw up for the first time ever our last show because I'm so out of shape.
Okay.
We're giving it everything.
So everybody's going to be jumping around, running around the stage.
Yeah. Oh,
all
yeah.
right, perfect.
We got here and there were seats all the way up to the front of the stage, and we were like, "That's not okay."
No.
We said no. So
they
took out a lot of seats. I don't know if all of the seats.
We're pushing them back so that people can stand.
Yeah, we want people
still
to like
be there, but no one.
That's perfect. I prefer it that way.
Me too.
All right, now message for your Filipino fans. Of course, everybody's very excited for you guys.
We just thank you guys so much for. we thank you guys for supporting us. We don't get to come here very often, so it means a lot that you support us from afar, and we're so happy to be back. Thanks.
We love you.
We love you guys too. Thank you very much, Paramore.
Thank you.
I really had a great time with my interview itself, but the best part actually happened after the interview. I think Haley and Taylor had something else to do after our interview, so they had to leave. But after a few minutes of enjoying the moment, dumating na yung shirt. Here it is. I'm gonna treasure this one. And maybe after a few wears, ipapa-frame ko na siya para hindi siya masira. And after a few hours, concert time. It was time for Para Thriller in Manila Part 2.
Ay, nakakaiyak pa ko pala sa Manila. Woo! Masaya kami.
It was such an unbelievable experience. I want to thank Faramore personally for showing up and giving me another great memory. And I want to thank Haley for inspiring me sa aking outfit for today. Thank you very much. I've been thinking about this, pero nakalimutan ko siya. It kind of slipped my mind for a while, and then she reminded me to wear it. And nakita ko siya during our interview wearing something like this. So I want to thank you very much, Haley Williams. Yeah, Bogut! And to you guys for joining me for today. Maraming salamat. I hope you guys enjoyed my experience with Paramore. This is our Rock Mix special called Paramore Now. I'm DJ Chino. Bye-bye.